food and just my favorite dish, hands down, had to be the sea bass. This intimate setting gives the chef a rare opportunity to meet the diners face to face.
Ladies and gentlemen, it was absolutely a pleasure for us to serve it tonight.
Looks like Evo selected some good fish earlier today. But as day breaks, on the second to last port entry of the cruise, there's trouble on the horizon. The trouble is, there is no horizon. New from Sally Hansen, special effects top coats. Transform any shape with three new miracle gel effects you've never seen before. For magical nanny and go beyond color with new miracle gel special effects top coats. Shop now.
Yeah, I have to pick up my Viagra, but this time I'm going to ask for branded Viagra. Last time they gave me the generic, but the branded Viagra is pretty much virtually the same price.
Viagra, you know the name? Ask for it.
You open the doors of our very first McDonald's in Canada. Lasting freshness? Try Burberry's Unstoppables Touch Fabric Spray. It doesn't just eliminate odors. The scent is shaken and sprayed to evolve the breakthrough power of touch-activated scent technology that lasts even hours later. That's because the Breeze Touch stores scent in your fabrics, so you get bursts of freshness with every touch. Your whole world will come alive. Welcome home to fresh with the Breeze Touch. Ask Sherwin-Williams and save big during the summer fun sale. Get 35% off paints and stains with sale prices starting at $33.14. Hurry, it's only July 29th through August 8th. Visit your neighborhood Sherwin-Williams store.
There's goodness in everyone. Cadbury Dairy Milk.
It's almost 8 a.m. on day 10 of Carnival Vista's Mediterranean cruise. After 9 days of clear sailing, the ship approaches Marseille, only to encounter a thick blanket of fog in the harbor.
At 5 o'clock this morning, I got a call from the beach officer of Yogi, and this building was deteriorating to the point of the zero now. We now have been through some checklists, we have reduced the speed, we have informed the pilot, asking the condition in Marseille, the armor, and we will have to wait a little longer than anticipated, so it means we might have a little delay on that.
In spite of Vista's advanced radar, the captain isn't taking any chances. He stops the ship outside the harbor. After 30 minutes, the haze clears. Finally, Vista can move into port. This might be the delay getting into port means he's still to sort out doors and buses again.
Well, I copy that.
Not every passenger is chosen to go ashore. Some fans are cheering on their favorite football clubs. Later, all remaining passengers are back. Another great day. No wonder. It's been an epic, mostly sun-filled trip across the Mediterranean. But it has required an around-the-clock effort from the busy cruise ship staff.
I wonder what
After less than 2 months of sailing, the flagship Mio Vista and its crew are already in rhythm. They're constantly hustling around the clock to feed, move, entertain, problem solve, and generally attend to the needs of more than 4,600 guests. For the passengers, this cruise is coming to an end, but it never ends for the crew.
This goes on for fucking 7 months. That's what my contract will be, and usually 7 days a week. That has been a great cruise. Thank you so much. Yes, to be happy with me, happy to be here.
This Mediterranean debut has established Vista as the flagship of the Carnival fleet. Soon, Vista will cross the Atlantic to sail the Caribbean from its home port of Miami. Whatever seas the ship sails, the view from Carnival Vista is sunny indeed. A high wire challenge tests the crew, and two missing passengers get a big surprise. Is the largest sailing cruise ship in the world. In every sense, this is a tall ship. 4 decks high, with 5 masts that serve 58 meters in the air. So its 42 sails can catch the slightest breeze and carry this ship to an amazing 17 knots, over 41 kilometers per hour, on sail power alone. Captain Bruno Barocca has been commanding tall ships for 14 years. But he first dreamed about it when he was an 8-year-old school boy. Which is about an hour's drive away. Its departure date for a 12-day voyage that will cover 2,200 kilometers. First, the tall ship will head south in the Mediterranean, with stops in the Pontine Islands, Sorrento, and the Sicilian town of Taormina. Then, head east to Corfu in Greece, north into the Adriatic Sea, visiting Montenegro, Croatia, and Slovenia, before wrapping up the cruise. It's labor intensive to load goods on this ship.
Coming on board. Food is very, very important. Food is a positive.
It starts with the cabins. Nothing escapes any of the sharp eyes. Prices start at $1,800 per passenger for inside cabins. And run up to $4,600 for this wonder suite. With its own lounge, private stairway, and a separate master bedroom and whirlpool bath. It's 10 minutes to embarkation, and the old-fashioned ways continue as sailors form a relay to hand load baggage.
Mark, you ready? Cocktails are getting ready.
Anita checks off the last-minute must-dos.
Before we start the vacation, we always notice that everything is perfect.
And if it isn't?
Then we have to improve us. Music's ready? Stargirds ready? Towers? Okay.
It's time to roll. There's room for a maximum 227 passengers on each voyage. And they share the experience with a crew of 110. It's love at first sight.
Absolutely fabulous. It's lovely.
At 9:45 p.m., the crew of Royal Clipper kick off departure. Followed by the square sails. Gathers on deck to experience the first thrilling moments when the sails are unfurled.
It's unique in the world to feel it's a step back into the 19th century.
The wonder of life, adventure, everything's in front of you. When you're on a sailing ship, and you can leave everything behind you and escape to a life of excitement. It's really awesome. Traveled
160 kilometers from Civitavecchia. Sails are up, but unfortunately there's not much wind to speak of, and the vessel is well muzzled by its two diesel engines. The tall ship is arriving at the island of Ponza, the first of two quick stops today in the group of islands known as the Pontines. Two tender boats are lowered under the watchful eye of Chief Officer Dominique Roland. Today, though, is almost perfect weather with a calm sea. As passengers head to town, they've got by 5 minutes to three, all the passengers have returned to Royal Clipper. Except for two women who have gone AWOL.
Please, if you're on board, just come and proceed to the end of the
cruise director Monia Salvati is hoping that the missing guests have somehow slipped back unannounced.
We must be sure that everybody is on board before departure.
There's a limit to the captain's patience. They should have left half an hour ago. It's time me because I'm having trouble reading.
Exactly. They sort of make